Morning. She took home third place and a $150,000 in the Regeneron Science Talent Search. 17-year-old Ellen Chu joining us this morning. Ellen, first of all, congratulations.
Thank you.
While most 17-year-olds are, you know, having fun, doing their teenage years, you are winning some big awards and making sure that people know who you are. So congratulations.
Thank you.
For those that may not know about the contest, what is it?
Yeah, so the Regeneron Science Talent Search is the nation's oldest and most prestigious science competition for high school seniors. And they're really about highlighting and celebrating scientific research from young people. So I'm really thankful, too, that they were able to bring me to such a cool event, and I got to meet a lot of interesting people and make really lifelong friends.
What was your project? What did you have to do, and how does it work to, like, apply to get the award?
Yeah, so in my project, I developed a deep learning-based early screening tool for a disease called Kawasaki disease. And Kawasaki disease is actually the leading cause of acquired heart disease in children, yet it's commonly misdiagnosed and lacks a specific diagnostic test. And how I heard about all of this is actually because my younger sister had Kawasaki disease when she was younger and was initially misdiagnosed. I'm really thankful for the doctors, especially at the UCSD Kawasaki Disease Research Center and the Rady Children's Hospital, who luckily were able to diagnose and treat my younger sister on time. But I know there are a lot of other patients who aren't as lucky, and so yeah. I basically wanted to see if I could do anything to help aid these doctors and make the lives of patients better.
So what was the project? What did you find in your research?
Yeah, so I investigated the possibility of using smartphone photographs to
smartphone photographs.
Yeah, exactly. You could take a photo anywhere and see, what's the probability of this image containing that of a clinical feature of Kawasaki disease versus its lookalike diseases. And so, since Kawasaki disease is based off of like a clinical diagnosis or looking at these clinical features and physical presentations, I was basically seeing if there's something that I could do to like utilize these smartphone photographs. And help people and patients be able to just upload an image and kind of screen for the early symptoms.
Did you always know like you're into science and all of this stuff from a young age, or is it somebody inspired you to want to do this?
Yeah, I'm inspired by a lot of people, the doctors especially, and people who really work to save patients like my younger sister and help her to, you know, she's the reason.
Oh, is this your younger sister?
Yeah, it is. Yeah, they're the people that, you know, got me here and made this possible, and I'm just really thankful for everyone who, you know, is saving lives around the world, and it means a lot to make a small ripple in this pond.
Yeah.
And that's really has always been the dream of this project.
How cool it is to be a big sister, and how cool it is for your younger sister to have a big sister like you.
Oh, thank you.
$150,000? Like they just give it to you?
Yeah, I believe so. I haven't really thought about it. I mean, it was never something I was expecting, and so it's a lot to think about.
What are you going to do with the money?
So I hope to continue working on this application. We're actually currently making this a patient-facing web app that patients anywhere can use, and so it'll actually hopefully be used to save lives. And I think if I can use, you know, the scholarship, it will improve a lot. I could go a lot further with the impact of this project and really make sure it reaches
the hands of patients. So you want to take the money from the third place that you got in the thing and then put it back into the work that you're doing instead of like going to Disneyland or something.
Yeah, that's the goal. I hope to continue, you know, pursuing research like this.
Yeah, I have a feeling this will not be the last time, Ellen, that we see you. In like 10 years, come back and talk to me here. If I'm still here, you've probably created something pretty amazing that's changing people's lives. So congratulations.
Oh, thank you. And thank you for taking the time to chat with me.
Always. Have a good day. Thank you.
Thank you. You too.